The Wikifreeze is the last day or last second that you're able to change your wiki. And historically, we see that teams tend, and I did the same when I was a team member. We leave the wiki changed to the last minute. So things can happen during the 48 hours, 24 hours before the Wikifreeze. iGEM Wikifreeze 2022, there was a crash. So hello, I'm Fabio Maschi. I'm a software architect at iGEM. So the previous system was a single server hosting everything. And the problem of this is, first, if this server goes down, everything goes down as well. And second, if we want to increase this server or increase the capacity, it's quite static. We have to shut down the system, get a new machine, move everything to a new machine, and start it again. In the new system, we can use 100 servers. We can use 1,000 servers. So there's no limit. We can do whatever we want. The minimal one that it's online is one. And then based on the demand, it will just automatically manage itself and it will just have a new server. The complexity of it is much higher. It's true that now we have to watch over 100,000 of parameters. This is the dashboard that we have access to monitor the status of the system. Then as we approach the Wikifreeze here, you see a jump in the number of requests per hour. Before, if the server crashes, then it would be a completely shutdown of the system. No one is able to do anything until we fix everything. Whereas now we can still shut down parts of the system, but keep other parts alive. So teams can still do some operations while the problematic resource is being fixed. For teams, they were working on the wiki. This was like about 27 hours before the Wikifreeze. The majority of them, they were on gitlab.igem.org, filling up their wiki, writing the HTML or the content, whatever. Suddenly, they wouldn't be able to save. They wouldn't be able to submit their code. So it would be a crash. So they would start like, okay, GitLab is not responding. They would refresh the page and then everything would be empty on their screen. They would, okay, what's happening? I cannot do the wiki. This is the response time that our system is having. So it went like from 0.14 seconds to 12. So this clearly means that there's something wrong, but we couldn't find it. What was the problem? We saw the effects of the problem, but we couldn't find the cause of the problem. There was one metric that we didn't know there was a limit, but the database had a limit of connections. It was something that we could never reproduce outside of the Wikifreeze. We needed a very high load to be able to find this problem. So we couldn't find this problem in any other day. We cannot really anticipate and map one-to-one. Let's say one user equals one connection. This is not how it goes. GitLab reuse number of connections and so on. So now that we found this one, let's just remove the limit. We had to increase the database capacity. We put the highest as available. After 20 minutes or 30 minutes of procedure, the system came back normally as usual. And then people start, okay, now I can see the Git, I can see GitLab, I can add it in my wiki and so on. So if this sounds fun for you, if you want to contribute to this, if you want to see this backstage during the Wikifreeze for next year, we have a Wikifreeze every year. Every year is a different year, it's the new year. So join us. I want to get out of here.
Come
replace me.